Hello, welcome to the Moon Dweller, and welcome to the second week of February. This week we have a new moon in Aquarius happening on Thursday the 11th, which I think is making this week super great because we get to focus on manifesting all of our visions. But before I get ahead of myself, let's take a look at this week's focus words found in your zodiac grid system. And if you're wondering what these words are, know that they are words specially chosen to help us understand that feeling or expression of what that moon will be offering us for when it is in that particular sign, zodiac sign, at that particular time. And I like to use these words to shape a story or a theme of what is, you know, cosmically going on around us, whether we notice it or not. And of course, I'm choosing to notice it. So we start off this week with a waning moon in Capricorn, giving us the word release scarcity. And what I think is so perfect is that, remember, the waning phase represents our cosmic exhale. We are detoxing, clearing out, releasing out, drying out everything that we don't want, which is really going to support us when we are working through this word release scarcity. When the moon is in Capricorn, it can bring up our fear of our security and not having enough. It can hold the pattern of limited resources and undervaluing things. So right now, we want to break away from those patterns. We maybe will address what are we undervaluing in our life, because the moon is asking us to work through this fear, to release that sense of scarcity, to feel full in just yourself. And so when we do this, you'll see that the rest of the week can really open to us quite beautifully. Then the moon moves into Aquarius, giving us the word inspiration. And so its first day in Aquarius is still a waning phase, but then its second day, when the moon has reached complete darkness, is when it will be our new moon in Aquarius. And so we have moved past our fear of limited resources and now can clearly see our inspirations and really let loose our new vision. And during this new moon, especially, we have to remember that Aquarius is the master of holding the new vision and creating these new visions. So your question for this new moon, and maybe meditation or ceremony, however you celebrate the new moon, you can ask yourself, what do you vision for yourself? After the new moon, the moon transitions into its waxing phase and moves into the zodiac Pisces, giving us the word bountiful. So now it's important to acknowledge that we just transitioned out of our waning phase, which was a cosmic exhale, and now have transitioned into our waxing phase, which is a cosmic inhale. And so we are regenerating, absorbing, building energy, and building strength. And so that, again, is perfect with our word in Pisces, which is bountiful. And how I like to think of this word is that I did all of that work on my visions and manifestations with the new moon in Aquarius, and now I am feeling really full all the way up to my head, maybe past my head, with those visions. I'm feeling just, like, I feel it everywhere in myself. I am living it. I am living in it. And what I love about this watery and dreamy sign is that it can take us to that dream land where that vision is manifested and already exists. And so just really feeling like I'm already living in all the work that I had just done the day before. Then the moon moves into Aries, giving us the word energized. And so I love it. We are still feeling that full bountifulness from when the moon was in Pisces, but let's do something with that energy. Aries is such an active time. This would be a really good time to go for a walk, or maybe do a yoga class or a dance class, or maybe that means doing a really big deep cleaning in your house, whatever suits you. But I know I am going to be moving my body, staying active, really letting that energy, that beautiful, inspirational, bountiful energy flow through me and, you know, touch the spaces around me too. That's week two of February. We started off with it being a little hard, you know, having to work through that stuff of when the moon is in Capricorn with the word really scarcity, but we can easily see that that work is going to pay off really fast for when we reach our new moon in Aquarius with the word inspiration, to holding those inspirations with the word bountiful for a moon in Pisces. And then we get to do something with all of that energy for the word energized when the moon is in Aries. But remember to take a look at the rest of your zodiac grid system to see what elements are in play and what body rulerships are happening as well, to further help you situate how you want to be in that week and organize your life. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next week for week three's focus words of February.
Thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe to the MD YouTube channel so you never miss out on the latest tips. Also, check out our Instagram and Facebook at The Moon Dweller for daily cosmic inspirations, and if this Moon Dweller calendar calls out to you, visit themoondweller.com where you can purchase this book.